Trust me, it hurts. Gif gif EL3FZFVP94LEEPXOP. What's more scary, a back-end developer who dabbles with front-end, or a front-end developer who dabbles with back-end? I'd argue the latter. Speaking as one of the latter, well, isn't every developer a developer who can develop with the help of Google or Stack Overflow? I don't know, Chrome Inspector is all you need, that and source maps. How else am I supposed to showcase my back-end? With raw HTML5 elements and tortured CSS? I have no business designing and styling websites. I accept this. I truly love full-stack dev work. But there are days when it just feels like, ah yes, I have just enough time to do 20 different things poorly. So I'm practically a full-stack developer just without the back-end part. Full-stack seems more like a generalist because now it's not just front-end back-end, it's infrastructure. A little awkward kubectl, some VMware O and then cloud. Ear other people's computers. Emo, just because someone can only create average front ends doesn't make them any less of a full stack developer. Shaq couldn't make a free throw to save his life, but that doesn't mean he isn't a basketball player. Outstanding UI UX design is an art form more akin to drawing or painting. One can possess an expert knowledge of the technical aspects of UI design but still not have the ability to produce a stunning experience. Think of the Steves expecting everyone to have the ability of both to even be considered full stack is just silly if you ask me.